Hello and welcome to a new Cryptomatics episode. To be the first to know when we publish a new video, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. For the latest news and reviews of the crypto space, you can also find us on our other YouTube channel, Crypto Robin. In the first part of this video, I'm going to explain what the pure proof-of-stake consensus mechanism on the Algorand blockchain entails and how the selection of validators and the validation process take place. In the second part, I will cover its advantages and disadvantages. What does pure proof-of-stake mean? In short, pure proof-of-stake is a permissionless consensus mechanism specific to the Algorand blockchain, which ensures full participation along with blockchain protection and good transfer speeds in a truly decentralized network. What makes this protocol a variation of proof-of-stake is that validators are not only chosen to participate based on the consistency of their stake, that is, the number of ALGO they own, but also through random selection, no matter how many coins they own. Their automatic selection is based on a verifiable random function. The VRF behaves similarly to a weighted lottery. Practically, each ALGO in the account of a participant would thus get its own lottery ticket. How are the validators selected? Within Algorand, every investor who owns ALGO can participate in the consensus protocol. To reduce the level of exposure, users don't use their so-called spending keys, that is, a kind of private key that they use to spend their stake, for consensus. Instead, whoever wants to participate as a validator within the protocol generates and registers a participation key. With this key, they can participate in proposing and voting on blocks. The use of such participation keys ensures the safety of a user's cryptocurrencies, even if the participating node is compromised. Every block in Algorand includes a so-called selection seed, which is random and unpredictable, and which determines and decides which users should participate as validators in the next round of the consensus protocol. When the new block is added to the blockchain, all users will see the selection seed. Each user who has proposed themselves as a validator can secretly check whether they have been selected to participate by evaluating a VRF with the help of the participation key they have and based on that selection seed. The need for computation is minimal, so even a device with limited resources can do this. The VRF computation thus produces a pseudo-random output with a cryptographic proof that anyone can use to verify the results. By holding or sending this proof, a user can demonstrate at any time that they have indeed been selected to participate in the consensus mechanism. How does voting work? This consensus mechanism requires three steps to propose, confirm, and write a block to the blockchain. Block proposal is the process through which the validating candidates are selected. First, each node analyzes the accounts it manages and, using the Algorand VRF function, determines which accounts are online and willing to participate, sending the information to the rest of the nodes on the network. Thus, each node receives a block proposal from the rest of the nodes on the network along with a VRF output, which proves that those proposals are valid. Soft vote. Here, each node will run the VRF, analyzing whether an account was chosen to participate in the soft vote committee. If the selection is confirmed, that account will receive a weighted vote according to the number of ALGO it holds. Proposals are filtered based on the lowest VRF timeout, with each node identifying a single option and sending it forward to the other nodes along with the VRF proof. Once a quorum for the soft vote has been reached, the process moves to the certify vote stage. Certify vote. At this stage, a new committee is selected to verify the block proposal that resulted from the soft vote. If no deviations are identified, such as overspending and double spending, the block is considered valid and the committee thus certifies it as such. The selection of the account specific to a node is now resumed precisely to achieve this final certification. These votes are collected and validated by each node until a quorum is reached, thus triggering the end of a round and requiring the node to generate a certificate for the new block and write it to the ledger. After that, a new round will be initiated and the process will start all over again. Conclusions. The pure proof-of-stake consensus mechanism is a variation of proof-of-stake in which the validators of a new block are not only selected based on the number of tokens they have staked, but also randomly through the verifiable random function. This mechanism chooses block leaders randomly, keeping the status of the validators secret until the transactions have been confirmed as correct. Algorand is the blockchain that created and uses this consensus mechanism. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and if you want to find out details about Pure Proof of Stake, don't forget to subscribe to the Cryptomatics channel. In the next episode, we will take a look at the advantages and disadvantages of the Pure Proof of Stake consensus mechanism. As usual, I am waiting for your feedback in the comment section.